Welcome to Most Life, where we have weekly Mo Chats. Our Ahead of the Curve series is someone who's changing the world in their way, bringing new ideas, fresh perspective, and inspiration to you. We will bring new faces, fun chats, interesting ideas, the Most Life system here for you each week at Mo Chats. Enjoy this week.
So today on Ahead of the Curve series, we have Abigail Forsyth. She's the CEO of Keep Cup, which is a company that I actually fell in love with at a half marathon expo in California in July. And Abigail, I'm excited to have you here on Ahead of the Curve series, where we are featuring people who are making a difference and innovating with what they are doing for a living and getting to know your story and your company. You certainly are doing that, so we'll explore that as we talk today. I'm very happy to have you joining us from Melbourne, Australia, so welcome to the Ahead of the Curve interview series.
Thanks very much for having me, Maureen.
All right, so like I said, I got introduced to your company and your products through the Race Expo out in California, Napa Valley, and immediately fell in love with the vibrancy of your product. Tell us a little bit about Keep Cup and how you got to the place you are right now with a reusable coffee cup, and tell us a little bit about your story.
Okay, so my brother and I ran some cafes in Melbourne, and over the years I became increasingly concerned about the amount of disposable cup waste that we went through from people coming in drinking their morning coffee. And for the Australian experience, the big thermos doesn't really suit the way we drink our coffee. We drink it sort of fairly quickly, and it all depends on the coffee being made under the group heads rather than tipping it. So off we went with Keep Cup. We designed the product. It's all about sustainability. In the world, there's over 500 billion disposable cups discarded to landfill every year, so it's about a million disposable cups a minute. So the problem is enormous, the task is enormous. So it's not just about selling the product, it's about getting people to reuse and make that a daily habit so they don't use disposable cups.
Wow. And so tell us about, you obviously went from running a nice cafe to becoming an entrepreneur in another sector, another industry, and needing to learn about manufacturing and that sort of thing. So tell us about the manufacturing of these cups.
So they're actually made in Australia, and that was part of the sustainability story. At the time we had no idea the business would go global like it has, and that's been a steep learning curve, learning how things get manufactured and dealing with designers and engineers, but it's been a great journey.
Right. And, you know, if I go to my local coffee shop and I drink from that and they have a recycling bin or someplace where they say, hey, dispose of your cup here, tell me about what some of the challenges are from that perspective, from the typical paper cup that everyone thinks is either made from recycled material or it is recyclable. What's really going on there?
What's really going on is you're drinking from a very thin plastic cup that's got a paper lining. So not only is it not particularly eco, and it's very resource and waste intense, it compromises paper recycling. So they can't go into traditional paper recycling. And what the statistic we always quote is that there's enough plastic in 20 disposable cups and lids to make one Keep Cup. So in terms of plastic waste, the savings flip over after 20 uses.
Mm-hmm. And have there been successes for those folks who are going to the Keep Cup, bringing them to coffee shops and having the coffee shop use those cups? Have you had a lot of success with that?
Yeah, we've had fantastic support from specialty coffee and from the roasters and baristas around the world, and they've been part of the drivers. I mean, they see firsthand that disposable cup waste, so they've, on the whole, been really pleased to refill and encourage people to use reusable cups. And a lot of cafes now give a discount for reuse.
Great, and I imagine your experience was, I'm sure it is, in many coffee shops, that you see the same people on a routine basis. So,
absolutely.
Yeah. So they come in and they're continuing to reuse. And I'm actually a tea drinker myself, so I tend to go maybe a little bit less frequently, but I do think about it now since I've gotten to know your company a little bit. And I will be. I have my handy Keep Cup that I got in California with me here with a little bit of iced tea in it. And when we have our Most Life cups, we'll actually be doing some giveaways to promote the colors and the excitement of having reusables and have some dialogue about people's experiences in coffee shops utilizing.
Fantastic.
So hopefully we'll be able to create some buzz about that and get some engagement. Tell us a little bit about what it feels like to kind of speak up about an issue and be a part of a community that's trying to make a difference in the world on the recycling issue.
Well, it feels fantastic. It does feel sometimes that it's such a tiny, tiny issue in the global waste crisis. But I think the thing that I feel really pleased about is often it's a keep cup is we made it all about fun and about colour and about great coffee and tea. So people are doing something sustainable without that being the primary motivation for what they're doing. And then I think once you transform it into a habit, it begins people on a bit of a sustainability journey. So you think, well, what else can I do? I need to use reusable bags, you know, composting. It starts your mind thinking and then you're on a journey. So that I think that for me that's a really exciting part about it.
Right. That's, you know, it's interesting. This week we are featuring a company named Urban Junket. They're in the Twin Cities area of Minneapolis in our country. And it was started by a woman who had a vision to create purses and briefcases utilizing recycled water bottles. And
oh, so fantastic.
Right now we're doing some promotion about recycled water bottles and her products and her company and kind of similar vision of having a fun, vibrant, colorful product that is attractive and useful, but at the same time having that extra dimension of taking care of the earth and doing something to try to minimize the human footprint on Mother
yeah.
Earth. So I think there's probably a collection of entrepreneurs out there who have created companies with a lot of fun products and useful products that are making a difference. And I don't know if you've surrounded yourself with some folks who you know that are also doing that and maybe creating like a community of concerned entrepreneurs, and do you have something like that going on?
Well, interestingly, I don't know if you've heard of B Corporation.
So that
started in the States. Do you know it?
Well, I've become knowledgeable about it since you've gone down that journey. You mentioned it to me when we spoke.
Okay.
So that is
a community of like-minded businesses. So it's about saying not only is business there to make money for shareholders, business is there to serve the community, look after its employees, and look after the planet. So it's about companies who are doing good, and it's an independent certification that you get from B Corporation, and there's a fairly rigorous testing done, and then you recertify every year. And hopefully, that means that not only are we, because we're asking our customers to go on a sustainability journey, it's only fair as an organisation that we continually lift the bar as on what we're doing internally to lessen our footprint and better what we do in the world.
Right. How many companies in Australia are part of that? Do you know?
We're part of the first, I think, 42. There's 42 certified when they launched a couple of weeks ago. I think there's 1,900 in the world. Most of them are in the States. So it started in the States.
Right. That's yeah. Excellent. And, you know, I know that once something gains momentum, sometimes there's a whole nother stage of something once it gains some momentum. I'm sure you feel that as an entrepreneur. And when I read about your interest in joining that certification process, which I knew nothing about as a layperson, not being involved in the industry, but that's really great that there's a real drive amongst business owners to have a multiple dimension business.
Yeah.
I think we are evolving as human beings and as organizations. When humans come together, our organizations, I think, are having a call to action to have multiple dimensions. Just as I think human beings are interested in their lives having more dimension, which is what the most life concept is about. It's about fulfilling multi-dimensional aspects of lives, not just being productive and having a nice family, but also enjoying life and exploring who we are as people and what we can do to both grow ourselves and grow those around us and elevate the entire planet.
Yeah, fantastic.
So that's I think your story with Keep Cup certainly resonates that way. We're excited to be working with Keep Cup, and I'm excited personally to know you, and hopefully maybe someday our paths will cross But we were, we'll be doing some promotions when this interview airs, and we'll be in touch with all of our great Keep Cup affiliates, and your folks in California have been super terrific with us.
Fantastic.
We look forward to that. And thank you, Abigail Forsyth, for speaking up for the planet and creating a sustainable, vibrant corporation that is setting the pace for other corporations, and it certainly resonates with Most Life and the folks who are with us on our journey. So we appreciate that.
No worries. Thanks very much for your time, Maureen. I really appreciate it.
All right. Thanks for joining us.
Okay. Bye.